We've all seen great bird photography like this where the subject is really nice and sharp and in focus, the background's beautifully blurred, and the bird is sitting on a natural looking perch, but it's actually all staged. How do you get these shots? I've been assured that it's actually quite easy. So I've come up to North Yorkshire to meet with wildlife photographer Simon Roy, who's going to show me how it's done. Hi Simon.
Oh, hi James.
How are you doing?
I'm good, thank you. How are you?
Yeah, good, thanks. Good. Looks like you've already got started.
Yeah, I'm just trying to set up a natural looking perch. I've drilled a hole in the top. So hopefully we won't be able to see it from where we're going to be shooting, and we can put some nuts in there and hopefully get the small birds that are in the area to land, and it will look natural. Obviously this won't be in, we'll be shooting from sort of this area here, you know, cropping this out.
That's one thing I wouldn't have thought of in a million years. Find a stick and drill a hole in it.
Yeah. Well, unfortunately I do spend a lot of time walking around just sort of finding dead wood and, you know, suitable perches, and then I take them home and dry them out and try and keep them for use in the winter when I'm shooting the birds.
One of the things I notice is that we're right next to a walkway. This doesn't seem like the kind of place I would think of to come and photograph birds.
No, well, that's the reason I've chosen this area because the walkway, people obviously walk along all the time and they actually put food on the posts, and the birds have become used to this area, so they're not so bothered about the, you know, the presence of people. If it was the middle of the wood, we'd find it harder to attract them in. So
where are they coming from? Because I can hear them all around me, but what's their route to the perch?
Well, they like the sanctuary of trees and bushes, so they would come. There's some trees here they would use, and obviously these bushes they would use. So they'll drop into them first, check it out, make sure it's okay, and then they'll drop onto the perch, hopefully.
So it's almost like a conveyor belt of photography. You get the birds coming through, get your shot, and then they're off and come round again.
Yeah, they just like the sanctuary. If there's a bird of prey like a sparrowhawk flying around, obviously they want to be able to get off the perch and get to safety quickly.
Well, shall we get our cameras out and start shooting?
Yep, let's do it. So the point of the perch, the way I've set it up is the hole, we shouldn't be able to see the hole where the food is.
Okay.
We shouldn't be able to see the food. The bird should land naturally on top, and we should just see the stick and the, actually there's a blue tick coming in now. you should be able to isolate the perch and get a nice clean background against the meadow.
Birds are obviously moving subjects, so should I be shooting in continuous autofocus or should I use single point?
I'm going to be using single point.
Okay.
And I would sometimes, if I had a really fast subject, I would actually focus, pre-focus on the perch. Because it's quite wide, it covers quite a lot of the focal plane, I'm going to really try and shoot the bird's head with a single focal point.
Do you know what? One thing I've just noticed, it's not that cold, but you're wearing gloves.
Well, the reason for that is that obviously our hands are like reflectors, and as we move to take the shots, any movement with our hands can spook the bird. So I tend to wear gloves all the time. It gets hot, but it does just, it's a bit of a field craft. It just keeps it safe. When the hand comes up, it can spook them and they'll go, too soon. So
I don't know why, but I still have these in my pockets, so I will join you.
Just leave the bird on the perch slightly longer that you get that shot.
So just that turn of the hand, it catches the sun, then it's off, it sees that.
Yeah.
So is it the same with your face? You cover your hands up, but if your face keeps popping up, does that scare the birds away as well?
It can do. I try and change all my settings with my eye to the viewfinder so that there's no jumping, especially if you're photographing things like brown hares or deer, that really would spook them. These birds are quite tame now, so they're not too bothered, but what we're trying to do is as they land, let them have a nibble and then just hold the shot until they put their head up, and then try and take the shot as the sort of catch light hits their eye.
So is it best for us to have our heads behind the cameras ready? Or?
Yeah, I would, yeah. Well, I mean, I normally wait. There you go, the blue tick's coming in now. So just try and hold, let them have a nibble, head comes up, hopefully without any food in it, as it should just look like the bird on the stick. Yeah. And what is actually good is once the food's gone, they will come in for a few minutes.
Okay.
And you actually sometimes get the better shots then, because they tend to stand on the perch, look around, give you a look of where's the food gone, and that's when you sometimes get the sort of more you know, more interesting shots. And I think another critical thing is framing, really.
Yeah.
You want to make sure that the bird, if you can, is looking into your image from one side with some negative space.
Okay.
For it to look into, you know, rather than the perch being here at the edge of the frame and the bird looking out the frame. So I will try and make sure I'll try and figure out where the bird's coming from, like here, and I'll shoot slightly to one side and give the bird some space to look into.
Yeah. So what was it that gave you the idea of actually drilling the hole in the wood? That is just ingenious. It's so simple, but it makes the perch work.
Well, I think the thing is, you obviously, what happens here is a lot of people put food on top of the post, and I see a lot of shots with food just on top of post, but obviously it doesn't look as natural. Well, drilling the hole and hiding the food,
yeah,
as long as you get the hole, you know, in the right position, then it does make it look like it could be anywhere, you know, a natural perch in the middle of a wood, and that's the key.
Do you know what, I just keep getting shots where the birds still have the food in the beak. I'm
just try and let them, they tend to put their head down, take a bit of food, they'll come up, they'll swallow it, and that's when you want to be taking the shot, just as they're sort of perched, natural, and if they turn towards the light, that's even better.
So generally they will always have that look up just to make sure everything's
they tend to sort of have a bit of food off, have a little look around, and that's when you want to try and take your shot.
Okay. I think actually getting set up, it seems really quite simple, but it's knowing the behaviour that's the more challenging part for a beginner. That's the thing I'm struggling with.
It's knowing how the birds behave, making sure that the perch is set up in the right place with the clean background, and making sure the hole's in the right place so you can't see it. And basically just, knowing the behaviour is key.
So they seem to be slowing down a bit now. I guess the food must be...
Yeah, as the food drops deeper into the hole, they have to spend a little bit more time on the perch, and that's when you can get some better shots.
Do you know what? I think it's a miracle. That's my first shot with the catchlight in the eye. The bird looks like it's looking at the camera and it hasn't got food in its beak.
Yeah, and I think everything's working. The perch, you can't see that food. The background's nice and clean. Obviously, the shadows are a bit harsh because of the bright day, and the tail's cropped off, which it's not good, but apart from that, you know, it's
I'm going to put that down to a disobedient model.
Oh, right. Okay, fair enough. Yeah,
I did try.
The tail was too long, yeah.
So let's have a look at yours. Let's see what you've done.
Okay, so this is the sort of shot I was hoping to get. The perch is nicely positioned. Mm. It's a blue tit. You can't see the food. And I've caught it just as it's turned up, so there's no food in the mouth, and the light's, pretty good.
That's
I'm
nice.
Quite happy with the robin. The sun had gone in then, so there was cloud, which is much better conditions, so everything's nicely exposed. I'm happy with the composition, and focus is on the head, so everything's nice and sharp.
Nice catch light there.
Yeah, nice little bit of catch light, and everything's sharp right down to the feet and the perch, tail, everything, which is what you're aiming for, if you can get it.
So that was when the cloud covered the sun for just a moment.
With a bit of cloud coming over, obviously changed settings slightly, I upped my ISO, it does mean that you can get more definition.
Yeah.
It makes the animal, especially if you're shooting birds and mammals, gives you more detail, makes everything stand out more.
So the assurances were true. It isn't actually that difficult to take images like that from a photography point of view. But the thing I've learned is that it's actually the field craft that makes the images work. And it always pays to do some research and learn the behaviour of the animals. So I think for me, I just need a bit more practice. So should we get some more food out?
Yeah, let's do it.